When do you expect the inflation to get back to the 2% range, which is considered normal?
I expect improvement by the middle to end of next year, second half of next year.
Second half of 2022.
Madam Secretary, when you were here last, and we all look forward to you coming, I asked you to tell me what you thought inflation would be at the end of this year, and you told me 2%. Do you still stand by that prediction?
Clearly, inflation this year is going to be above 2%. Just the experience so far this year makes that clearly true. But I think we are seeing monthly inflation rates taper off.
Yes, ma'am. What do you think it'll be at the end of the year, if not 2%?
Probably closer to 4%.
Okay.
And that's already almost must be the case based on what's happened this year. But in my estimation, there are the types of supply bottlenecks.
Where do you think inflation will be at the end of this year?
Well, let me go to 2022.
No, if you could go to the end of 2021 first for me.
So I believe that my expectation, although there's a lot of uncertainty, that those numbers will come down.
But by the end of this year, you expect the inflation to be more than 5% or less?
I believe that the monthly numbers are likely to generate annual inflation rates. I believe that will come down toward 2%. But typically inflation rates...
Secretary, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but my question was pretty simple. Right now in May, on an annualized basis, we both know what that means, inflation was 5%. I know you're not clairvoyant, but where do you think it will be at the end of this year?
So the type of inflation number that you're talking about compares the level of prices the month.
I understand that, but I'm asking I'm asking you,
inflation
based on a year ago. This is not a complicated question. I'm not trying to be rude, but this is not a complicated question. We're at 5% now based on where it was a year ago. So now we know what we're both talking about.
For the rest of
Will it be higher at the end of this year, or will it be less?
12 months, I believe it will come down.
You think it'll be less by the end of this year?
Than 5%, yes. Prices the year before.
I understand.
And that will...
I've got a limited amount of time, Madam Secretary. If you think in 5% inflation in May, and you think it'll be less at the end of the year...
Yes.
Then why did the Federal Reserve announced that it was going to, thought they were going to have to move their interest rate increases sooner and faster than what they had originally expected?
Well, I don't really want to comment on the Fed, but I would simply say that is not an announcement that they made.
Well, the market sure reacted. Sounds like the Federal Reserve's worried about inflation.
I would just refer you to the comments that Chair Powell made in testifying yesterday and at his press conference.
Well, but I'm talking about the action the Federal Reserve took. The Federal Reserve met recently and they said, look, we know we told you this, but things have changed. And we're now telling you that we're likely to have to raise rates sooner and faster. Let me just finish. Than we originally told you. Why do you think they did that?
Because
they're concerned about inflation, aren't they?
That is not what they did. Several individuals wrote down in their own individual forecasts, which were published, that they saw it appropriate to raise rates sooner than previously.
Why then did the Federal Reserve last week raise the interest rate on excess reserves?
That's a technical adjustment that they made because the federal funds rate had fallen to the very bottom of their target range, and it was a purely technical adjustment. It's not appropriate for me to discuss Fed policy.
Well, sir,
I don't want to comment on...
It is. I'm not asking you to make Fed policy. I'm asking your opinion. And usually when the Federal Reserve raises interest rates on excess reserves, they're trying to contract the money supply.
No,
They're trying to contract the money supply is because they're worried about inflation.
It's a purely technical adjustment.
Let me stop you because I've only got a minute left. Here's my worry, Madam Secretary, and I hate to have to interrupt you, but we only have so much time. I know your job is to put the best face on it, and I understand the Federal Reserve's job is to put the best face on it. But inflation at 5% annualized gets my attention. When the Federal Reserve says, or even certain members, they say, nothing to worry about here, nothing to see, but by the way, we're probably going to have to raise interest rates sooner and faster than we thought. And when I see them raise the interest rate on excess reserves to get money out of the money supply, that tells me they're worried about inflation. And here's my question. Nobody's clairvoyant. A lot of these experts that you talked about never called the recession in 08-09. A lot of these experts at the Reserve, at the Federal Reserve, what if they're wrong? And the president has been adamant that he's not going to raise taxes on middle-class Americans. He's allowing that to happen right now because inflation, prices are rising higher than wages. And 5% inflation is a tax. It's a tax on food. It's a tax on energy. It's a tax on everything. And we can say it's temporary, but the actions of the Fed indicate to me they don't think it's temporary. Your thoughts?
Madam Secretary, I'm going to have to leave it at that, Senator. We'll have another round.
Others went over, Mr. Chairman.